America, we are live because it says so on the thing.
Because you can read?
Because I can read, yes.
I am the proud. You can do the read.
I can indeed do the read. I can barely do the write, but I can definitely do the read.
Yeah, well, writing's becoming obsolete anyway.
Which kind of saddens me, actually, but that's the point. Close all the porn.
And we're live. Now I will close the porn.
Get the stream link up. If you want to post this on your Facebook, you can. Not sure if you care or not.
Yeah. I'm pretty sure that anyone that would care on my channel would be the one looking at your thing and caring, but I'll just reblog it on mine. Or share it, whatever.
And we get a no drop frames. That means last week it was most definitely the interwebs. Anyway, hello everybody. I'm Dawari.
And I'm Rita Green.
And welcome to Mega Man Battle Network 1.
The first.
The first of many, actually. I'm glad. First of many. I love this series. Oh my god.
And I might as well be a noob to the series. I remember trying it. I don't know if it was Battle Network 1 I tried or 4 or whatever. I remember probably playing a little bit and not really getting that far because I then got distracted by something else, probably Pokemon. So I really do appreciate the series. I really love the mechanics for the series. But my knowledge of the series is comic.
I'm going to say it now. Battle Network is a lot better than Pokemon.
I'm not going to argue that point.
Never quite attained the fame that Pokemon did, but this is definitely a better RPG series. I want to read the text boxes, but I can't be bothered right now. So we're just gonna let that be done organically, as it were.
What?
Okay, so Mega Man Battle Network. The titular character you are playing as is Len Hikari, 10-year-old school student, and his partner, Mega Man.exe. Mega Man in this game is not a robot, but in fact a computer program.
And more importantly, he's a protagonist who has a dad.
Another point in Mega Man's favor, because, you know, Mega Man actually has a dad.
Mega Man actually has both of his parents. Well, Len has both of his parents.
No.
Well, yeah, technically Mega Man has both of his parents.
We'll get to that when we get to it.
I love how the headband on Lan matches the helmet from Mega Man. I think that's just adorable.
And for evil-eyed viewers that know their Mega Man lore, that poster in the background is actually of Mega Man Legends, and that pixel mess is Mega Man 1. Email. We have a dad, but he's generally not around that often because he's very, very busy.
He's not quite a workaholic. His work has just kind of swallowed him up.
Yeah, no, he's not a workaholic. His work is just very, very, very important. Literally. Probably the most important guy in the world.
Now, is that coming from the fact that you're his son, or...
Little bit of both, but he actually is just really important. Anyway, we're gonna go off to school. We've got
our first... also like to introduce to everyone the wonder that is roller skating indoors.
Yeah, another point in Mega Man's favor, because you cannot do this in Pokemon. Yeah. Why did he give me a cross gun? Well, to be fair, we'll help with Bulbasaur a little bit. Really, cross gun C?
He's going to say a lot of things about folders and chips, and I'm going to sit here and I'm going to stare at the screen, pretending I know what recovery thing does. Probably heals health.
Unlike the typical Mega Man games, which are usually side-scrolling platformers, the Bownette series is actually a...
Oh, it's actual dog food, okay. I wasn't sure if it was a cereal-themed
sort of turn-based RPG sort of thing. It's not really turn-based in, like, your Final Fantasy, it's more,
Well, actually, the original Final Fantasy games, from what I played from Final Fantasy 1... Oh, hey! Some girl who knows my name.
This is male. As you were saying about the original Final Fantasy games...
It actually was, it was turn-based in the sense that everyone had turns, but it was timing essential.
Yeah, it worked off the action command system, I think, the first game. I think, I'm not sure.
Right, so the reason I lost to the first boss miserably is I was like, oh, it's my turn. I will go immediately. Not realizing that it was prudent to wait. I didn't realize that waiting was a thing.
Yeah, some, I think 6 and 10, 2? Something like that?
Where, I don't know.
So, Final Fantasy 6 is a good game. I'm just not good at it. Now, that's besides the point. This here is Mel. She is the 10-year-old female side character to your 10-year-old male protagonist.
So does she have role?
Yes, she has role.exe.
Okay, there you go. That's all I need to know.
Uh-huh. Fucking love role. Role's so useful. Not in story purposes, but like she gives useful item. A useful item. Let's see, does this initiate? Oh, let's save this, that's why I have to do all that exposition. And this fat son of a is Dex. Initially, he was meant to be like a bully character for the series.
And then the child who's balding.
Yaya in a giant forehead. We'll get to Yaya in a minute. But after the second game, I think they kind of dropped that angle with his character. But we'll see that as the story goes on. And then there's Jai with a giant forehead.
So we've got Reflect Man and Fish Man.
There is actually no Reflect Man in this game. And obviously there's no Fish Man. Fish Man would be great. Oh, okay, so we're not gonna get, Oh, hi, Ron. I've not been looking at the chat box.
Aw, man, class is starting.
Yeah, so, apparently
it's okay,
we've
Fish Man.
Avoided a beating, as it were. I don't know why. Obviously, Dex is meant to be like the token black guy in the series, hence why his looks are like that. But it's
why
just a very, very, very poorly done representation.
Yeah. Do they think you guys evolved from the sea? Do they think that's what happened to Atlantis? Like,
yes, the Japanese think that all black people are descendants of
Atlanteans,
and that we all look like fish. Little do you know is that black
people. What is up with that puppet child? Wait, hold on.
Oh, you mean generic NPC boy number one?
That's a boy?
Yes. Question mark. To be fair, the NPCs after like the first three games get a giant. No, wait, no, they don't. I think they get revamped in 6. What am I saying?
I just know that there's a creepy doll in the classroom. How do we know that the EXE hasn't been downloaded into a mechanical body and is now just an NPC?
I mean, you're very much overthinking this.
Maybe I'm thinking this just the right amount.
No, I think you're...
This is how terrible fanfictions are born.
We're not doing terrible Mega Man fanfictions. Those days are behind me. Those days are so behind me. But Dex is... fuck off. Dex is the operator of Gutsman.exe. We will see more of Gutsman a bit later after we're done with this cutscene. I'm not gonna lie, I'm not paying attention to any of the dialogue. I'm just leaving it here so that people can read it. I'm not reading it. I refuse. Oh, wait. Ah, yes. It is time for the obligatory tutorial section.
Oh!
The tutorial section that you are never allowed to skip.
That was a cool thing!
Yeah, no, the net transitions are always nice. And these are all the navvies.
Why don't the navvies get chairs?
Because, I mean, I really don't know. I don't know why they have desks, to be fair. Like, they're programs. I don't know.
So wait, we're not allowed to net battle, but she's teaching us the net battle?
Well, because the overworld in this game is the internet, so and you're running the viruses on the internet. So it's a matter of, you're not allowed to do this in school.
Ah.
But outside of school,
This is how you survive outside of school.
Okay, I'm going to skip through this. I can explain that system a lot better. Okay. Battleships are your basic attacks. They mirror the copy ability from previous Mega Man games, such as Mega Man Classic and Mega Man X. Now, you have a couple attributes when it comes to ships, and the battle system will get a revamp later on. But you can have either any chip with the same code, which is that little letter at the bottom of the chip, or any chip in the same type. So as you can see, I've selected two cannons. Cannons do 40 damage, which is more than enough to take out the Oh, that is a good message. Adorable. I'm surprised we haven't got questions in these things. Capcom doesn't market their things really.
So what I'm hearing is that I have to play poker with the chips.
It's kind of like it's very much like a card.
So it either has to be the same. Same suit?
As we're learning now,
or the same number.
Yeah,
okay.
You can use chips of the same code in combination. So we're gonna use a steel and then we're gonna use a white sword. And
because they all have the same letter?
All the same letter.
Okay.
Good folder optimization comes from either having mainly comes from having chips of the same code in your folder at all times, as well as chips of the same type, if possible. I'm exploiting a little glitch that was present, I think, in this game, number 2. Usually the Mega Buster fires really slowly, starting out. But if you dash up and down the road, Rosa acts kind of like a machine gun. And the closer you are to your enemy, the faster you actually fire, because it acts as if the bullet is traveling across the screen. It's actually pretty neat for a game at the time. And now we're just getting into the ad function, which works really, really great in this game, but they change it drastically as of 2 and onwards. So you just hit the ad button and you get 5 hits eventually.
I'm watching what's happening, and my brain has processed how this works. So there's any letter from A to Z?
Yes, and asterisk, which acts as a wild card.
Okay, so asterisk can be used with any letter suit?
Yes.
Okay. So we have our jokers, cool.
We have no boost. And that was plus.
I should open up Twitch on my phone so I can see the chat.
Yeah.
So I can ignore it properly.
And this is... you wish to hear about PET from what? Yai's gimmick is that she's very, very young, but she's incredibly smart, so she gets skipped over like a couple grades. So whereas everybody's like 10, I think she's like 6.
Okay, so she's the one who knows way too much.
Yeah, she's literally the one that knows way too much.
Okay, gotcha.
And it is a running joke that somebody at least has to make a joke about her forehead at least.
Yeah,
so far as
Reflect
to,
Man.
So far as to in Battle 3, she falls down the trap door, and because her head is so big, she falls head first. It's actually a really funny arc.
I can't. I'm done.
Okay. Basically what she said is that the device that we carry around that holds our net navies is called a PUC, which stands for personal terminal. And this is a gut one.
Because it's after school now, so we're going to fight.
Yeah, technically we're not too fighting either, but Gutsman, first boss battle of the game, to get you used to actual AI, he hits very hard at the beginning of the game, and he cracks out. But once you have one tunnel cracked, he's not really that much. which is his shock waves can't touch you at all. So he's just gonna jump about the screen, doing thing.
Now it's not gonna crumble until you get off of it.
Crack panels only crumble when you move. You gotta be careful though, because he can box you in. And panels obviously regenerate after a period of time. Oh, yeah.
What's custom?
That is the quote-unquote card menu.
Oh, okay. Oh, so that's your turn thing.
Mm-hmm.
How long you have to battle until
this is why I said this game is kind of turn-based.
Okay. Because starting to comprehend.
Yeah. Your ability to select actual chips is set on the timer. And you can only have 5 chips on each one. Well, maximum 5 chips on each one. And oh yeah, you don't get anything from beating this time. Sad. So that was pointless. Wow, I didn't even get money. Fuck this.
Wow.
Nope, can't jack into the board. Okay, so basically.
Ooh, go find some. Right. Let's have a snack.
Yep.
Does he at least know what food's like?
No, he does not. We will get to that when we get to it. Spoilers, as it were. This is Dex's house. I believe it's going to be an apartment building, actually.
But that's why we're bigger than the door?
Yeah.
Okay.
Isometric view. Little up. And this is Yai's mansion. Actually, in later games,
look at them trees.
The layout will eventually.
Oh my gosh, I love those trees for all the wrong reasons. That squirrel.
What is this kid doing? Why are you running in a circle?
He's clearly trying to pirouette. Oh my god, what is it with people with foreheads in this game?
Oh. foreheads are a thing. That's all I've got for you. And this is where Mel lives. Right next door. Next door neighbor's friend's life. Ah, there we go. I knew I could jack it somewhere. So the act of logging into the internet is known as jacking in. Yeah. Hilarities will be had, hardy, sections.
Shotgun K.
Which is also useless, because...
You don't have any other Ks?
Yeah, no synergy.
I'm doing the learning. Mm-hmm. They're the cutest fucking viruses I've ever
seen. I know, metals are adorable. Alright, let's see if I can find some chips. Try not to take as much damage because that does affect ranking. But I think I'm not really gonna get anything to do.
Does your folder reshuffle every time it
Every battle your chips get reloaded.
Okay.
So
Oh, who's that random NPC?
Oh, that's a Mr. Pro. They're basically programs. That's what they're meant to represent.
Okay.
So I guess in terms of like real world computing, they would be applications.
Yeah.
No, because technically that's what NetFans are, because they're executables. I really don't know what the hell their equivalent is.
They're just there.
They're just there to be cute, basically. There's. Why was not that not a cannon C? Bullshit! I really wanted a cannon C.
Aldo.
Yeah, but they just do things in the internet. If things go on in the internet.
They kind of seem like they're the background programs.
Pretty much. They just run shit, basically. So, you'll find them in.
So they have the OSs in the background.
Whatever a machine's function is at the time, Mr. Prog will perform that function. So, the doghouse actually doesn't has a dog in it. It's actually a security system, which, in case of home invaders, plays the sound of a dog barking, just in case.
What? That's great.
Pretty much.
Oh, who's this random guy in your house?
Ah, yes, unique NPC. He's here fixing.
He must be a bad guy. He has his own, you know, model.
No. Whatever would give you that idea.
Why are we still watching the same dog food commercial?
Because your mother has nothing to do with her time. Because
we have no dogs.
We did have a dog at one point. As you can see, there's a dog house in the back.
Are you sure that's not just... Wait. How do we know that's not just the front of the house?
Because we just came in through the front of the house.
Yes, I know, but maybe that's just another security system dog house.
It could be. We'll find out eventually.
So, are we just convinced on... to try to convince other people we own a dog? Like,
yes, this is the clever ruse that we have right now. We are trying to convince people that we own a dog, and that is scary. Rawr, 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 bark, bark, bark.
Bork, bork.
To be fair, like, I don't think real world crime is a thing in this world anymore, because all of it's cybercrime. Those are the only crimes I ever hear about.
Go to your room so you won't get in the way. Just.
Mom's gonna fuck the repairman now. Because dad is not home.
Dad's never home.
But yeah, no, he came to fix something. He's there to fix the oven. Don't know why he's dealing with the control panel in the,
Because obviously he has to connect to the internet to fix the oven.
Yeah, no, because everything's connected to the internet now. And this is Glide. Glide.exe is the EXE version of Glide from Mega Man Legends 2 and Misadventures of Trombone, actually. This is Yaya's life. He's useless. Doesn't do a damn thing. There's literally no point to him existing.
Wait. Something of hers is missing. I have to go do the dishes. That's what I just heard.
Yes. Oh, obviously, something's gone wrong in this world, so we have to deal with it.
Our dying dream, is that wrong?
Yep, that's wrong. You know what? I really should not start with this game. I should start with map 2 or something. Because now I have to remember the internet layout. I'm probably gonna have like download some maps or something. When I'm done here. Because...
Are those E's spinning in the background?
Yes. E stands for internet, don't you know?
Ethernet.
Yes, Ethernet.
Alright.
I'm assuming what they were going with is like internet, the logo for Internet Explorer. That's the best explanation I have for this. Because,
Yeah, it does have a thing orbiting it.
Mm-hmm. So it's like, we stole this from Microsoft, but it's gold and doesn't have a squish thing around it, so it's obviously ours. Yeah.
Just punctuate that with a yeah.
I'm trying to remember.
It's trying to target you.
Oh, okay, yeah. These are the hitscan cannons, so I'm good as long as I keep moving.
What?
Alright. Fuck! The way cannons work in this game is, as long as the reticle's on you, that's where it's gonna hit. But it has no actual line of sight.
So it's spot fires as opposed to beam fire.
Yes.
So it has no actual trajectory path.
Yeah. Unlike with my buster shots, they'll hit down the road. The cannons just appear on whatever the hell you're standing on. This is the only game where they do that. Because they realize that was kind of BS and you could cheese the game out. And I could never remember which game it was that did it. Honestly, no.
Alright.
But yeah, this is your main overworld. The internet. I don't remember when Battlefront 1 came out. I think it was 2001. So this whole net navy internet thing was a really, 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 really interesting concept at the time. And as we go through the series, we can kind of see how a lot of real world how the internet itself kind of shares a lot of parallels with what we have in this game. It's really interesting to see what they kind of predicted. I mean, nothing major like Simpson predicting Trump being president or some shit, but it's interesting.
So what happens when you're using items, or rather ships, of different letters?
The only way you can use ships of different letters is if they're the same type of ship.
Oh, so you just can't?
You can't use ships of different letters unless they're the same type of ship. So I can use Kenan's Kenan ships that are B and A, B, and C, but I could not use Kenan's A, B, and C and then let you use Sword S.
Okay. So say you had Kenan's A, B, and C, and then you had Sword C. Would you be able to put that in with the Kenan's? Okay, no. So they all have to be of one flesh or another.
They all have to be one type, or else you can't use anything else.
Okay, so it's just a rummy hand. Mm-hmm. Okay, cool. Alright, cool. Yeah, you thought I can only compare things to Pokemon. Now I'm comparing things to Rummy. Haha.
Well done. Mega Man is the instant transmit. He can look. Mega Man is basically great. So. He shoots blue lasers, trains to get stronger, and walks backwards. And he can do math.
Did you say he can do meth?
Yes, meth.
Oh, math. I thought you said meth.
Actually, I'm trying to remember if he... Oh, how...
What does Met Guard do?
It does exactly what it says in the tin. It's a god chip.
Oh, so it's protect. Got it.
Yeah. Okay. Sorry, I've changed my button mappings over and...
It derped.
I derped. I'm trying to fucking remember how the... Spin meth man. Oh, and we actually got it, so let's show what it does.
Let's reveal! What?
Basically what it's meant to do is when an attack hits it, sends out a shockwave as a counter attack. But I think in this game it stays out really, really briefly. So it's a bit more timing heavy.
Oh.
Met God G. Actually, I think that's gonna be useful though. Not now.
Access portal.
There it is.
Super spring.
What?
It looks like a spring.
No, it doesn't.
It does though.
You're blind.
You're blind. You have no opinions. So I imagine the sword can only attack an enemy that's right in front of you.
Yeah. Swords attack right in front of you. Wide swords attack down a row. Yeah, row. And long swords attack the column. One column of front. I'm not really gonna be getting that. I deserve that for part of it. You know what? I'm not even gonna worry about taking damage right now. Yes, I am actually technically on somebody's Twitter. Well, technically, yeah, I guess I'm kind of on somebody's Twitter page. More like homepage?
Yeah, it's like we're on her MySpace page.
Yeah, no, I'm on Angel Fire right now. Angel Fire. I'm not sure if you guys had that over here, but it was called Pixel, I think it was.
I remember hearing about it.
Basically all those, hey, I can have homepage fucking things and have bad songs.
I can have a webpage for my dog.
Mm-hmm. Where people put like skulls and no era hats, no fear logos, and I'm sorry, this is probably different from what you are into, but
we had forums, which we would design the whole forum.
Yeah, that too. But
it was our pro
back
boards.
In the day, the big thing with websites were the No Era Eyes with the angry eyes, where it said no fear. I'm not sure if you know what I'm talking about.
I think I do.
Yeah. There also anime was big, so a whole bunch of like anime stuff. And
so like, everyone would have their Bugs Inuyasha Bunny smoking pictures.
Joints. Bugs Bunny smoking joints, that was another big one. All the Looney Tunes characters with bling and shit.
Yeah.
Ah, good times, good times.
I hate that genre.
I don't know how the fuck they even came up with it. Taking such beloved characters and bastardizing them like that.
So, cool. Why is Shiny Togekiss mad at you?
Shiny Togekiss. That's just how this thing works. If you're in line of sight, it charges it.
You know what? It's more of a Sharpedo. More of a Sharpedo.
Okay. As for the ranking systems, you're basically ranked on
Oh god, now you have cannons and Sharpedos. Bomb them. Bombs away.
You're basically ranked on how many the way ranking goes is it goes by how many chips you've used in the battle or how fast you beat it.
So if you use fewer chips you get a higher rank?
Yes.
Okay.
Obviously, that's impossible to be given with. And she has diamonds as the background, so she's it.
Yes. That's her desktop.
Mm-hmm. I'm not going to care about losing health in these battles right now because the nifty thing about Battle 1 is that you recover health every time you leave battle.
Oh, wait. So, like, you'll actually go to full health after leaving the battle?
After a fight, yes. So, like, I could
that's
be
cheating.
No, it's not. That's how it was. This game was programmed. This game's programmed really differently from all the other ones. There's a lot of bullshit in it. A lot of fun bullshit.
I want to heal my team, like, for free between every battle.
Yeah, no, that would be great. But,
yeah. Yeah, that would defeat the purpose of the League 4, to be honest. You just whiffed.
Yes, I do.
You whiffed so bad.
I have, Jolly Flying Man, I have played every game in the series apart from Battle Chip Challenge, because Battle Chip Challenge sucks, and 4.5, because I do not read Japanese. And I will actually be getting to 2 and 3. Maybe later in 2017. Hopefully, as long as I'm still alive.
I like swashy, swashy. And that thing's just not gonna move, is it?
No, they're cannons. They don't move.
Cannons can move. Turrets, though. It's a turret.
No, it's called a cannon, because they're implying cannon, because it's cannon, they're dumb. Therefore, it doesn't work.
That would be lame. Kinda lame.
They are,
as dumb as if they can't speak.
They cannot speak.
So, alright.
I don't know why you're arguing this. Technically, I'm right.
Get your technicalities out of here.
Actually, I wonder if I could pull this off. Like the time is shot just right. Not.
Well, it did a thing.
I'm not sure if you could do it in this game, but I think if you shoot a shotgun just right, because it shotguns hit the target and then whatever's behind the target. And because these things move, I know it's easier to do with shockwave chips, which we will get eventually.
So wait, it's able to register as behind itself if you do it right?
No, it will hit in front, it will be hit on one panel and then run into another hit. But I'm not sure if you can do it with shotgun chips in this game. And more cannon ears.
You need all the cannon ears.
Actually, what I need is a cannon see.
Why? No, okay, is A weaker than B weaker than C?
No.
Okay.
Nope, I have not gone where I need to go yet. I've gotten lost. You know what? I should have actually read the text. I think I know what I've got to do. I've got to go and find something and then bring it back to everybody.
Looks like we're still inside the PC. Want to go look for the lost program?
Yeah, that's what we gotta do. Find the Mr. Prog. So, Battlenet 1, although a good game in its own merit, is a terrible Battlenet 1. Gonna be straight up honest. For a first outing, this game is great. But when compared to the rest of the games in the series, there are a lot of minor bugs that make it terrible. For example, we'll see later on down the line when we get to new areas in the internet, just the overworld internet, you'd think that they'd look distinct from each other, but they don't. So memorizing the map in this game is fucking horrible.
So what I'm hearing is that they realized there were flaws in their system and they fixed it.
Oh no, the jump from 2 to 3 is mind-blowing. I mean, I'm not 2 to 3, but from 1 to 3 is mind-blowing. They fixed a whole bunch of issues, and it's a much better game for it. But 1 is not something I generally go back to, because it literally is.
Cannon B!
Yeah, I need to get like a rank 10 or something to get what I really like.
So, why do you need Cannon C so badly?
I will show you when I get a Cannon C.
So, okay. One's not inherently better than the other.
But there is a perk to having...
one suit or another.
Yes, to having chips in the same code. Either there is a perk to having chips in the same code or chips of the same type, if you know exactly. So
they have buddy powers?
We will get to it when we get to it. 5 more HP. And I want to save up for that power. Oh, wait. Oh, or I can save it for a Cannon C. I just left the pedal wrong. Why? Why you gotta be like that?
Now, are the combinations between the chips like just a list of recipes you end up memorizing over time and over exposure, or?
In this game, yes.
Oh, good.
There is a chip library. Like, I'm gonna actually try and go for 100%, which means I need to try and max out the chip library. So, for example, these are everything. This is everything you have here. I think in 1 there is a total of 150 standard chips, then mega chips, and a whole bunch of different chips.
Mega chips or boss chips?
Generally, yeah. I think that's the perfect word.
I'm getting the concept of how to play the game. How to master the game is looting.
Yes.
Me.
Okay. Something I can actually want to use. I don't really have facility. There we go. This is what I'm looking for.
Why not just? Oh right, because it's a program, and if you put it into the wrong file or move it through the system, you might damage it, or you might damage the system.
You're a figure.
Or maybe I'm providing necessary context.
You're overthinking this.
Maybe I have a beautiful mind and you just don't value it as far as my commentary goes.
Maybe.
Anyone just overthinking this?
Maybe you're just overthinking this. If I've gotten a fucking rifle and a spear, I'd go right off the bat.
Now, is this instant transmission sprite because they didn't want to animate him walking around? Or because, like, They want him to look cool.
It's meant to be that he's hopping between the panels. That's all it is. Like, you'll notice with the bosses eventually. I'm not sure if you were noticing when I fought Batsman, but he was actually jumping like entire distances in the level.
Yeah.
So that's basically what that means. When it comes to movement in battle, we can only move either up or down one square. I mean, forward or backward or up and down or up and down one square. And you cannot move that way.
Okay, so we're a King Rook. Got it.
Yes. Actually, yeah. That's going to come in handy later.
Oh, it actually explains the difference between all the chips on the summaries that you're going too fast for me to read. Okay.
Yes. I know I need to go get dinner, but I want to try and grab some Zenny to get ready to see you.
What just happened?
Okay. It means I have dinner to go.
Okay. Fair enough. How do we know the repairman's not leaving yet?
Because he hasn't finished his business and we haven't looked at the internet and finished it off.
Oh, that's right. Time is relative to our perception.
Mm-hmm. To be fair, all these Met Gods are going to come in handy later on anyway. Wait, perfect. And that should... Fucking hell.
Okay, so why are your folders kind of random?
Huh? Well, it randomizes the folder whenever you go into that. If you start off the same chip, you start off, basically. Later games would allow you to register a starting chip that you would always start the battle out with, but obviously you haven't got to start yet.
Shockwave K.
Not a shop FC, but if I get more shop FKs, then I will put the most of this. Yes, it's not gonna be there. Get more money, it's gonna be worth it.
So I imagine it's capable to flee a battle?
Actually not for a while.
Really?
Actually no, I don't think fleeing battles is even a thing in this game. That may not be until number 2. There is a chip specifically designated for fleeing, which is that little running man strike that you see in the chip.
I figured.
But apart from that, not really. Actually, what I'm gonna do is just log in and out with you and see if I can find money by getting chests.
So you're gonna glitch spawn in money?
Pretty much. If I can find Julius Rudolph.
So. Okay, so the chests in this game respawn?
The chests in this game work as dust. There are 3 separate types of data in the other world. You'll find green, you'll find blue, and you'll find purple. Blue is a one shot. Green, they randomly respawn, I believe, whenever you log in or out. And purple are one shots, but they generally contain like really rare items. So
okay,
and they're
so they're super blues.
Yeah.
Okay.
But purples, I don't think are in this game. Yeah, no, purples are definitely not in this game.
Okay.
Because purples usually require items with a lot.
My brain is so sluggish right now because of all the stuff it's processing.
I think that's cool. That is save right here.
How did you see that?
I saw the little sparkly pixel colors right there. One thing you can do in this, in one.
Why can't you activate it?
Is you can save right in front of the chest. Soft reset, and it will reset what's in there every time. So I might be able to get lucky and get like a. No. If I can get a decent money amount, like maybe 500 is only two. Let's see if we can shoot lucky.
You're mitigated cheating, I'm seeing right now.
This is not really cheating. This is exploit. Completely. Ah, there we go. That is what I like to see.
All right, so one more battle and you've got that chip.
Mm-hmm. One more battle and I've got my, never mind. Yep. All right, alrighty then.
Look at this blatant reward of...
What, exploiting the system?
You know, you're gonna use up all your luck in the beginning of the game, and then you're gonna really need it later on, and you're just not gonna have it.
No, I know that's gonna happen, because there is, like, in the endgame areas, there is a specific virus that I'm going to need to spawn, and it's a really, really low spawn rate. It's a low spawn rate, first of all, and the way you defeat it is completely shit, and I'm going to, no ifs, ands, or buts, I'm using safe states.
Jesus.
It's called Rush. It's, as in Rush the robot, not from the original series. And the way this virus
what
works...
What will you buy?
That's all I want right now. One Kennedy is enough for me. I will save the rest of my money and then come back for the power-up.
Folder!
So now... Kennedy.
A, B, A, C, A?
It doesn't matter what do you put in the Kennedy. I'm trying to remember if I can get one of these. Yes, I can.
No, my brain was trying to process that as a song format.
And another bullshit thing about another one is that in the later games, you will be limited to how many. There we go. How many of the same chip you can have in your phone at the same time. So in later games, it's 4. In this game, it's 10. So all the cannons. All the fucking cannons. Some would even say cannons to the left of them.
Cannons to the right of them.
Cannons in front of them.
Volley. Volley. And thunder. Oh boy.
I am gonna. I don't know what I'm gonna say. I am gonna read Mystery Data Spam again later. But let's move on with plot.
Yes, thank you for advising me that Scream, I know, is my mother.
And oh no, the oven we just got fixed is suddenly on fire. However could that happen?
She's a communist!
I was trying to cook hotcakes in the afternoon. Mom, what's wrong with you? It's not breakfast.
She's
time.
A communist! She's calling them hotcakes instead of pancakes. How un-American.
They call them hotcakes at McDonald's.
Yeah, well, they're a corporation. They're allowed to be wrong. They're allowed to break the law. Point is, your mother's a communist. You have
How
to throw
is
she
in the a
oven.
Communist?
She's not calling them pancakes, and she's having them in the afternoon. This is terrible. She's breaking all the rules.
Okay. Anyway.
Doesn't she have a net navy? Like, I thought everyone had net navies in this.
That's a question that we never have answered. I'm not sure if your mom ever Ah, yes, Firefield. Love this track.
You say Firefield, I think Mega Man, and all I hear is burned to the ground. So...
Get to that game in the fucking game. In maybe 5 to 10 years. We still have to get through Mega Man X. There we go.
Here we go.
So I have to get through Mega Man X 1, 2, 5. Definitely not a shotgun Q, mate.
What's wrong with shotgun too?
It's got no synergy.
Well, I thought you said if, you know, you're too young to be dealing with Q.
Unless this is a fix. I think this might be a fix one, actually. And if it is, I'm going to be kind of upset. Yeah, I think that's a fix one. Never mind. I tried. I got really, really unlucky. Because of the heat in the oven, work has broken up. I can't do this.
Maybe you could put it out if you get the ice block from the thawing section of the network.
Ah, okay. So that's,
Day Signature WWW's for sure, and it's tough. It's just like Mal was saying. Let's go, Omega Man. Battle routine set.
Oh, yeah, I forgot to mention. I think Mal got into it. Really?
Really what?
At this point, we've fought, like, 15,000 of these things already. Those metals. And this is gonna be really tough. They threw one at us. Just one. Oh, wait! Oh,
he's down! Love him!
How much did that raise you?
Give him a hug! They're being deleted! You have to save them!
I'm trying. I will get to that in a minute.
I have no antivirus.
To be fair, our dad's like one of the best former scientists in the world. How do we not have antivirus?
No. They don't have antivirus because they're compromised. Their antivirus is compromised.
I think the home of one of the former scientists in the world has very chip skills.
Yeah, well, that's what happens when you give a 10-year-old access to all of your security protocol.
Well, yeah, that will prove himself to be very, very competent. As time goes on.
He's still 10.
And for 10, he does a lot. I don't think that's the experience. This would go by a lot easier. The only drawback to cannons is that they have a long cooldown period.
Busting level 6. Delete time 6 seconds, 8 milliseconds.
Yes, I'm gonna give this to every fucking left you down.
Sword B.
They give you some weird.
Sword B.
I think this is this one's fixed too. Ah! Oh no!
Oh no!
The illusion, it's been ruined.
Sword B. It's fixed, okay? Just accept it.
It's hard for me to remember which ones are fixed and which ones are okay.
Phone. I got this text 2 hours ago. You can stop telling me about it.
And that should be an S rank. I don't know, that's 9 again. Is this the following section? That's
Steel A.
Never gonna use that.
No!
I'm on.
Hold on, I have to go on Etsy to see if I can get a plush of those programs.
You're probably not gonna find them.
Probably not, but I'm gonna go out there and I'm gonna look.
I think Battle Network is actually the most popular one. Really sad.
Yeah, definitely is.
That'll do.
They have the badges, and they have a custom Funko, but...
A custom Funko?
Yeah.
Make pop figure out everything. Here's the thawing section.
Use ice block. Oh, I didn't read it. Okay. But yeah, there's no plush of the program guy.
We got seven of these.
Oh no! Meteor mash. I just realized. The explosions are just red trees.
the explosions are just red trees. Okay.
Look at the animation that they use for the fire, and then look at the trees. They're the same. The one's red and one's green. I love it. Trees are moss fire.
Okay then. All right.
Whoa, silly kid.
I believe it's meant to be pronounced World 3.
World 3?
World 3. Everybody I know that played them called them the WWW. Because obviously, WWW.
Yeah.
But no, World 3. No, never in the games is that explained to you. World 3 is a much better name. But it makes no sense.
I'm still gonna call them WWW.
You're gonna call them WWW?
WWW. My command isn't responding. How about a fire extinguisher?
No, actually, you're gonna love what we come up with.
I'm done.
Because.
Go, again, Squirtle!
Again, we are 10. To be fair, that's probably like one of them backpack super soldiers. Put on over his backpack. And we're just going through here. Surprisingly, no fire-based viruses in this fire level. But yeah, okay. Speaking of, back to a point I was making before, notice how this network looks significantly different from the other ones we've seen.
Yeah, drippy.
That is only a thing for the dungeons.
Ah, yeah, so dungeons have a thing.
For the dungeons are like mini PC, mini computers that are actually.
I can't even get Google to bring up the likeness of these little program guys.
Well, are you typing the name of it?
Probably.
What are you typing in?
Mega Man Battle Network Program NPC.
They're called Mr. Frogs.
Mr. Frogs? Mr. Famous?
Oh yeah, Mr. Famous is a thing.
Oh my god, they're so cute! Oh
wait,
my
can
god!
Can I do it? No, I can't do it yet.
Aww.
But I can do this. Kenems to the left of them, Kenems to the right of them.
Holly.
Holly and Thunder.
Are there golden frogs?
Yes.
Oh no, this one's just fan art of Navi as a Mr. Frog. Okay.
What? I'm trying to see what's more to go through.
This one's art!
Oh, we'll get to them later.
What?
That's a thing later.
Oh, okay.
That is actually a thing later. That is something we never get to see ever. That's a thing later.
So, looking at its design, it might actually be hard to do with fabric if you want to be exact.
I don't think so, actually. I wouldn't say that. I wouldn't say that.
I think it's because my brain would want to actually do the beveling of the metallic pieces.
Well, you can get like a metallic fabric for that.
The beveling?
I'm not a fabrician.
What?
I know what I said.
No, beveling is the rise and fall.
I'm Fireman. Fireman.
What?
This is Fireman. I love Fireman's design in this game, right? The consistent thing with Mega Man Battle Network is that it takes all of them.
He looks like a Shelmet gone wrong.
Shelmet is.
You know that thing that switches with a Selgor?
And becomes a Excalibur?
Yes.
Okay. First of all, came out first.
I understand that.
Back to what I was saying.
The point is, he looks like a Shelmet gone wrong.
Fair enough. All the bosses in Mega Man Battle Network are based off of the robot monsters from the classic Mega Man games.
Right. That makes sense.
And obviously, they all get touch-ups. Some of them good, some of them bad. But Fireman, generally, I think is one of the best. Because it's the closest to the original design. But looks a lot more intimidating. But yeah, this is Fireman. He shoots fire. That's all I have for you.
So he's the flamethrower, Navi. Mm-hmm. He's pretty fast.
Try and hack.
And my first thought is, I'm mad. He can travel in diagonals.
Yeah, no, I'm mad too. We can't use that in a boss fight. I should have got rid of these, actually. These are completely useless.
You're not using any more of your cannons?
No, I'm waiting for something.
You kind of got hit in the face there, dear.
Thank you. You're...
Why can't you use it?
No, I can. I don't want to at the moment. But let's mill up a little bit. No, Fireman's actually surprising. And we have to go through the process all over again.
I'm sorry, dear.
That's the thing about the ad system in this game. Yeah, you get the entire row. But if you, once you pick from that lineup, it resets back to the original 5 chip lineup. So, again, a lot of kinks up.
So you can't steal it while he's on the panel, right?
No, I can. I actually do damage if you steal it while he's on the panel. I'd rather have the entire road to myself. But Fireman is relatively easy.
Because he's very predictable in that sense?
Yes. And he moves really quickly, but his attack come out really slow. So he generally gives you enough time to react. The thing that's probably going to catch you off guard the most is the fire tower, which is the flamethrower that
curves around. Yeah.
Yeah. And this is why I wouldn't defend this. This is called a programming box.
Okay.
So generally, if you have 3 to 4 of the same chip, or a series of chips in the same code, you get a superpowered version of that chip.
So, run that by me one more time.
Okay. So, for example, think of it as like a flush, or trips.
Okay.
It'll be perfect. So if you get a running set of chips,
okay,
of a specific chip in the same code,
uh-huh,
or 3 of the same chip. I believe the code does matter, but I'm trying to remember. You get a souped up version of that chip.
Okay.
So with cannons, it gives you infinite cannons for a specific period of time. And when you hit with those cannons, the cannons actually hit, I believe, 2-3 times.
Okay. Cool. Alright, excellent. Cool.
Which is why fold synergy is really, really important.
Gotcha, because that's how you... Okay.
Yes. And that is a note... I'm trying to remember this. No, Program Advanced Library is something in this game, too.
Okay, so I typed in Mr. Frog to Etsy, and I got flip-flops for Pink Floyd's Dark Side of the Moon.
Flip-flops for Pink Floyd's Dark Side of the Moon.
That's what it said.
Why? In short, Mr. Match, that was the guy's name, was sent here. He's been installing viruses throughout everybody's ovens, making them set fires because we're the world free and we're evil.
Well, that, I mean, you're potentially burning down someone's house. That's some serious shit. And considering that if your dad really is that powerful, then being able to murder his family and disrupt him entirely is a very good tactical plan.
Well, actually, this attack wasn't just orchestrated against us. I believe Mel's house was targeted.
Well, you don't want to make it look like intentional arson. It'll just look like the ovens in that area malfunctioned because of something they were connected to.
Well, that was basically the point. Yeah. But yeah, no.
The puns begin.
Oh yeah, no, the computer puns and the Battle Network localization, two things you will always hear and see: computer puns and terrible, terrible grammar. Actually, I'm hoping you're reading this. I really am.
I am.
Okay. Because I'm not going to notice the grammar.
No. When they're atrocious, you will know. It will be a good reaction.
No. I will not.
No. You'll get it from me.
Oh, okay, fine.
I will make it painfully clear that they have made an atrocious error, and I have to write an angry letter to their mothers.
But I've been playing this series for a good, what? Okay, first game came out in 2001.
Yeah. No, if you're tired, we could go to bed. It's the internet. Ah, yes, child of our own imagination.
Oh, yeah, no, that's how every child functions in this area. We should go to bed, but, like, there's something on the internet I need to do. Five more minutes. There's a couple of things I want to do on the internet, but yeah, let's see if this works. It should be.
I was gonna
ask. There we go. Because it travels down the row, the hit animation for the truck wave is still traveling down the row, so it runs into both.
Gotcha.
Very nifty. Especially when we deal with different versions of those viruses that leave fire trails on the road. It's a good way to get rid of them. Ah, and time to money scamming. I think that one is actually like almost always there.
Enemy Dorited.
Dorited?
Dorited. They're Doritos now.
Good.
What is even that? That wasn't grammar. That's okay. What was that?
What was that even? Alright, 500, that's good. I'll take that. Actually, speaking of that, that question, there is actually a whole bunch of things I want to do.
What's the spreader?
Namely. Oh, spreaders are basically shotguns, but they spray.
Oh, okay. So they're the prey and spray, got it.
Yeah. Shotguns spreaders are actually great ships. They spread out from the initial impact of where they hit.
We have a really generic background. Can we change it?
No, we cannot. We get very used to the floating golden ease. Love them, live them, breathe them.
What if I wanted floating, well, I don't know, pictures of myself?
No, you can't have that. There's nothing else in here that I don't need that recovery 50. I'll get one of those definitely. But, pick a power up. Some more HP.
Wide Sword K.
I will not be getting Wide Sword K because, as far as I'm aware, the other sword chips do not come in that chip code.
Has Roller Skates ever played this game?
Yes, actually, he has.
So in that point, did he try to make Mega Man Red the entire game through which I imagine is a different game anyway?
That is a different game.
And did he only fight with swords?
The one game I know he played was 3, and he actually was yellow because he liked the X.
Okay.
I'm not sure if he's played 1. I do not know. But...
Because I can just see him with an entire folder of swords.
If he did play 1, I assume. Oh yeah, we finally got the charge shot, by the way. We just bought the charge shot.
Yay!
And the charge shot in this game is actually very good because the number. It has two stages of charge. Uh-huh. Represented by green and, I guess it's pink or fuchsia, one of the two. But probably I think fuchsia.
Fuchsia is a very computer color.
Oh, he's not here yet. Okay. Never mind. Come back here in a minute. Wrapping this up.
Good night, Lan. Good night, Mega Man. That squirrel's wanted.
Yes. I think the damage values on the charge shot and buster attacks, because you have 4 or 5 upgrade pots for the buster, they go up in stages of 4, I want to say. I'm going to say 4, because when we shot that cannon, it did, 16 damage?
Mega Man! He's so fighting an upward hill! Yo, get up for school. No. Get up for school. No. Get up for school. No. Why didn't you get up for me for school? I swear to God.
Oh, no. Mega Man is great in this. This is why I love this Mega Man, because he's so fucking sassy. All the sass. And, like, later games, you get to change his personality a tiny bit with programs and whatnot. Bayonetta 3, because you get the navigator. Oh, it's just great. It's great. Like, the power-up system gets taken out in Bayonetta 3 and replaced with the Navi customizer system. And you can actually install programs. So it's like baby's first program. But not really. because there's no resemblance to actual programming. But, what's this? Tech speak. Student crime is on the rise. And schools everywhere. Notes for class. Oh, this is the stuff that we got before. That was the tutorial. This is a refresher. Oh, I forgot. That just gives you a power up program. Oh wait, no, it doesn't.
He says he made one. Oh, okay. He'll probably give it to you soon.
Yeah, so I'll probably get it at the end of the day, I think.
You can press PETO button.
Oh, no, the P... but yeah. So you get little programs that you can influence what Mega Man says when you press the L button. So, for example, there is a program called Humor in Battle 3 and 4 and 5 and 6. And Mega Man tells corny jokes.
That's
really,
nice.
Really... No,
super like B-rated
unbelievably terrible jokes.
That's
so
that guy
bad.
Was grinning at the gate. Oh no!
No, he's obviously not suspicious.
How do people not notice him?
Because he pit pats instead of skates.
What?
Temporary substitute teacher, I'm assuming.
No, teacher's aide.
Yes.
Which, considering she forgot something and had to send you an email, means she already knows how to handle her mistakes, so I don't understand why he's here.
Because he is here to help, and he collects chips, and he's looking forward to trade chips with you. Yeah.
See, even Reflect Man gets it.
I wouldn't say scary, I'd say more goofy. I love Higsby. Higsby's great. I mean, we're not going to see how great Higsby is for a while, but he's great.
Oh, I
want
to give him a warm welcome. His hair has more life than I do.
Hey, man, do not diss Higsby's hair. Higsby's hair is, like, the best hair. Oh, yeah, she's going to tell you about program classes. Can I battle you again? No, because he's been beaten before and he needs to get upgrades. Can I jack him to the board yet?
Oh god, all these puppet people.
No, not.
Chat with everyone.
Yes, one of these obligatory talk to everybody sequences.
It's hard remembering all these ship codes. It's the alphabet.
It's the American alphabet. This is obviously Internet Japan. It is actually Internet Japan. There is actually Internet America, though.
Point is, we only have one alphabet, and it's actually short several letters.
Not true. Internet Japan has three alphabets.
Right, and American alphabet only has one. So why is he struggling to remember American alphabet?
Because he's not an American speaker. I think we're missing an L on that well.
Wee!
So what, he comes to the class and he squeals? Wee! Children!
Wee!
Seriously, you're not doing well to make yourself endearing to kids.
Oh, okay. Percy comes in, impersonates a pig, and then makes it look like he murdered your teacher. That's good.
It makes it like he murdered your teacher. That's a conclusion jump.
First class will be study hall. What?
What?
Why would first class be study hall?
I don't know. Don't you?
Then why is everyone yelling at me for being late?
I mean, because you shouldn't be late to class. It shows a lack of discipline.
Don't address just yet. Oh, God. What? Then it's a math class.
No, it's study hall. Didn't you hear? Didn't you read that? He said it's study hall.
Yeah, but study hall is... Oh, God. I'm gonna curl up in this chair. I'm not... Go away, Mr. Wheel!
Oh, no! He broke the blackboard.
It's a woo-woo-woo education program.
What do you mean? That's not Dr. Wily. That's obviously some other nefarious villain.
The woo-woo-woo's true plan is to start a war. The end game. Not to be confused with New Game Plus. You will take control of the military net and all the other nets, but not the real military, because fuck that. Who needs that?
Well, actually,
the only
that
cure for this rotten world is... Giratina.
Giratina? You're getting your cannons mixed up. And technically, no, the military net is the real military.
To reach our goals, the woo-woo-woo is hiring new staff members. What? We'll begin a new instruction program starting today. Children, study well and become good slaves to the woo-woo-woo.
I mean, forcibly indoctrinating children into your...
Okay, so hold on. We have these puppets that are actually AIs. Who, I can understand them being actually scared, because they're like, holy shit, if they're going to discover us, they might delete us. Or they might reprogram us.
Wait, what?
The puppet children that are...
They're not puppet children, and they're not
they're
AIs.
They're totally wayward Mr. Progs that want to be, like, want to have net navvies to protect
wayward
them.
Wayward Mr. What is with these conspiracy
Because,
theories?
Okay, clearly we have Mr. Progs that can lose their antiviral, so they want their own net navvies. But apparently you have to be human to have a net navvy, so they've made robots.
That's not how the story goes at all.
Well, at least you have to be fish people.
No, this is just a class of ugly children.
How do we make them all individual so they're all really memorable? Make them fucking ugly.
Well, more like creepy. These are like stepford kids. It's like, oh my god.
Okay, so we have Atlantean and we have Reflect Man.
That up or that article.
Look at his arms! Look at him go! Look at him go! Look, the puppet children, they just want to be defended, and now look at them. They're very freedom, both from the side of being human.
I actually like this concept, that every Navi, every person that has a unique Navi, they have a backup of that Navi just in case it gets deleted. And the idea is, whenever we get a game over, is that Lan doesn't back up his shit. So, Mega Man gets deleted, he's generally gone. Which is why the game is over. Obviously, saving is meant to be back.
Yeah.
But I think it's implied in the universe that Lan just doesn't back up his shit because he's a terrible computer. Like, a lot of computers.
That's a relief. Okay, Lan, you're up. Show us your stuff. Lan, please! Let's do it, Lan.
His voice is not that deep. His voice is... He's a net level, but he's also a child, so... Oh yeah, I have to talk to Mel first. So we can get one of the greatest things ever! Roll! Fucking love Roll.
Transmit.
Step into a thing.
The woo-woo-woo must have done this.
But yeah, two dungeons back to back. I want to say we can finish this before 9:30, but I don't think that's going to be the case. So we're just going to go until we go. There's nothing back here. Interesting thing about this network is that it actually emulates the coffin layouts.
Why is Glide here?
Because
we didn't see Yai Jack in.
We don't need to. Ignore me running.
What did she do? Plug into the bookshelf.
Actually, possibly. I think that there's a dragon put in one of the books.
I know you guys can't see my facial expression, but I know you know which one I have.
What? Ebooks are a thing? I don't think they were a thing in 2001, but I mean, somebody had to have the idea. Why not Unifina?
So there's just the nook. Just sitting on the shelves. And all the children are ignoring it.
Yes, this is a world of futuristic future stuff, and children with little AI companions and things, and fucking hell.
They're adorable! What is it?
They're
having my voice, Jesus.
These are flappies. Because they flap.
Is that their canonical name, flappies?
Yes, that is actually their canonical name.
What?
Yep. They flap. Big, scary flap-flaps.
I need a big, scary flap-flap in my life.
Actually, I don't think we get the names of the viruses in this game. Later games will, like, whenever you're fighting something. And that's quick one. They are basically like mini bombs, but they do a lot more damage. And they crack hammers. Oh, wait, there's a thing. Actually, I think that's a HP memory. I really wish I could just one hit within this game. I really do. I hate fighting these things.
I don't blame you. Like an elephant with, like, toilet paper stew stuck on its face.
I mean, I guess. Fuck you, butanks. I hate butanks.
Press A button. I think they meant the A button, because it's highlighted funny, but it's just press a button.
Oh, shockwave out. Yeah. Unfortunately, having different letter shockwave chips does not result in a program of bots. So, yeah.
Flap.
You can usually tell when there's a program of bots with one chip because the letters will be in ascending order. Or alphabetical order. Oh, wait, I have a charge shot. I completely forgot about that.
Yeah, that's Fuchsia.
I can't remember the numbers on these charge shots. Wait,
5. Okay. So, how long has the background been counting down to 0?
it just counts down because this is a school. Oh no, I'm sorry, it randomizes because this is a school. Actually, this is a perfect enemy for me to find out what method is. Okay, so your initial charge shot does 16 damage. For your buster shots that do like one damage per hit, that is a huge improvement.
Yeah.
Wait, hold on. Do you want to go to the lock? Yes. Sometimes the long way is the shortest. Okay. Don't remember what that means, but fine.
Okay.
So I believe charge shots, they go up in increments of 4 or 8. Number of chairs is 5A, and this is the gimmick of the dungeon. You've got to look at the real world and get numbers to answer questions. To be fair, a lot of these you can just cheese and just guess, so it's not that big of a deal. And if you guess wrong, why is your face like that?
What? Wait, why are you unlocking the door and running away?
Because I think there's a thing here.
Not bad.
I always know when there's a thing.
That's not true.
Fine, I usually know when there's a thing.
You have a sense for a thing.
Yes, I have things for it.
I love how you can kind of almost see him going backwards, just like, nope.
Yeah.
No!
This is why I hate these things. I always end up running into the bombs. So it's not that I hate them. Ooh! No, but we get sharp roll anyway, so it's okay. That looks like multiple hits, but it's actually just one. It's just one hit that does 6 damage and then heals you for 30.
Oh, okay. So it's just a set thing.
Yeah.
I thought it was like Mega Drain or something.
Nah. Not that lucky.
Is there like a super roll?
Yeah. Navi chips, they generally go up in increments of 3. So you have version 1, version 2, version 3.
So roll a death.
Pretty much. Yeah. I know there's a HP memory around here somewhere, but I can't remember where it was exactly. Yes, it is. Oh no, it's a high
eye.
Oh, a high five. We'll definitely test out one of these.
A yokai.
Actually, yeah, it is a yokai. You're right. I hate this sensor really though. Okay.
Who got it?
They're unbelievably quick. If you get them down to a certain amount of health, they heal.
Ooh.
And you can't hit them with anything that is like as slow as a cannon. They'll just jump right out of the way. Irritating shit.
So they're what Piccolo wanted Gohan to be.
Yes. If you have to make an allegory for it.
Hi, I'm gonna steal your yard. I moved your fence. I'm the worst neighbor.
What is wrong with you?
You got shot in the face.
I deserve that. I got greedy.
I like getting greedy in a game. Hey, frog.
All the way. I am not dealing with that virus combination. I think history of the world is over here. Or is it over here?
No, those are all virus busting. Is it another classroom?
It might. No, actually, because we can't get out of the classroom. Oh, wait, no, we can. Okay.
Because remember, we were supposed to check the other classroom.
So, history of the world is probably in here, then. Ooh. Oh, one more, a new program of arts. No, not here.
Oh yeah, they mentioned the library.
30 volumes, there we go. Oh wait, this is a library?
Yeah.
Huh. Never noticed that.
It only says lib, and it was only the passcode to the library. Oh, that's right, you don't read.
I didn't need to read the text. Yeah, you can literally just wing the passcode, and it will tell you if it's too high or too low.
Oh, I was just gonna put in 0, because the password was none.
No. Smart, but no.
Verification figure. Okay. Oh wait, because you entered it too many times with
it. Yeah, it reset, but it only reset the second digit, which is lucky. All the money. What the heck do you want to buy now?
Let's lick the gate.
To be fair, that's a very shit security system. There's a HP memory.
HP memory.
Mm-hmm. Now I got 160 hit points. Caps out at 1,000.
Crossing. Can run. Greeny green. Pink. Well done. Met Corday.
Yes, okay. I'll be dealing with you for those Met Guardians to a full effect later.
Remember Dorothy's for?
I wanna say it's 5? 1, 2, because that's not the rule. 3, 4, 5, 6.
Did you forget the main doors?
Well, it said in the school.
No, in the school.
Oh, in the school?
Yeah. And not to mention there was a kid standing in front of that door last time, so maybe you have to go through it.
Okay, so 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11. 12, 13, 14, 15. I want to say 15 then. This is a double
door. We did it! See, my observation scores only work in the beginning.
Oh joy.
Hey, Flap Flap! See, because these came first, the sentence structure is supposed to be Bronzong reminds me of the Flap Flaps.
I know, you've seen Bronzong first, so.
Exactly, so my brain orients it as Flap Flap reminds me as Bronzong.
No, more than understandable.
And I'm thinking that it should go with your first experience as opposed to. Seed to run this?
Yay!
Yay!
New program events.
Oh!
Are you lost? No. Just trying to remember where all the figures are. Yeah, and she only and she gets better. She only ever gets better as the games progress. This is actually probably the worst version of all.
What is that hand?
It's a hand.
Okay, it has 4 fingers and the worst cuffs I've ever seen. Oh, those are the spreaders.
Because
uh-huh. You just put spreaders in.
Yes.
I'm learning.
I think as of Battlenote 3, Roll is actually a multi-hitting chip, as opposed to a one-shot. So when you actually use attack up chips, it powers up every hit she does. So it basically doubles her attack.
That's great. It's a bomb hand?
Yeah, it just plants that bomb.
I don't remember what the circles on his sticks are.
The what?
The chip that's a circle on a stick.
What circle on a stick?
The chip. That one. Oh, it's recovery. Okay. Because I'm just looking at the icons on the bottom. I'm not actually looking at the giant thing. Escape. What happened to this classroom?
I have no clue.
Whoa, knows no bounds. They ruined a classroom.
Truly, they are insidious. Oh, bosses, they jumped.
Okay. Flap flaps are terrifying. I love them.
Flap flaps are terrifying. I love them. Greatest statement. I'm actually really looking forward to getting Resident Evil 3 because 3 you can break open so easily just by the power of math.
Yo, flat blocks are kind of like a cross between...
Oh, shit, I forgot about this. And I'm going to be here. That's not suspicious at all.
Why are there... Why is there a classroom in the AV room?
Audio visual room, so they probably have like lectures and stuff in here.
Oh, so this is the trash cans. Got it.
Yeah, it's just about remembering which one it was. I don't think that should technically, by computer logic, affect Megaman. Because he's his own... he's a program of running on that network, so I guess if there was,
Then he would default to the network as opposed to the computer that he was stepping in?
I don't know. I forget how... I don't really know how this works. What they're using for...
So, it works because future...
No, there is legitimate computer logic behind it. I just can't process the logic right now. Because basically, what happened is that that computer ran out of RAM to run applications. That's exactly.
It's like when I full screen Monster Hunter.
So
that was nearly the day I died.
It caused everything to lock up basically, including Mega Man because he is an executable.
Yeah.
Actually, no,
there was I had a thought and it was gone.
Magic number 69. I'm not sure if that's always how that ends up with me, but somehow I think I've had that happen quite a few times.
I might make myself a plush flat flap.
So you want a plush flat flap and a plush plush Mr. Frog?
Well, flap-flops are going to be easier to make, so I'll start with the flap-flop. So how come you couldn't claim that top tile?
Huh? Because he was standing on it.
But I thought it just hurt them if you claimed it.
It does.
Oh, and it fails. Actually, they absorb damage and it fails?
Yeah. Actually, I don't think it hurts them in this game either. I think that's a concept brought in from number 2. You know, number 2 just finds... 2 refines a lot of shit. A lot of people... when it comes to the hierarchy of games, people generally think number 3 is the best. And 2, probably second best, I'd say. It's definitely the best one to go back in. 2 is probably the game that I would go back and just play. On a whim. One of the easiest ones 100% because you don't have to do any more clockwork. Oh, wait, hold on. There's something else I can do. Let's see if I can do this. This, or is it not here? Oh, okay, it may not be in this game. Nah, it's not here. So I guess I can't... Oh no, I guess I can't 100% this game then.
That's right, because you need to have pretty well... Oh! Well, I don't know.
You did
you might
want to
leave it like that.
That last week, and you gave me an F. I'm not sure if I... I think I need to renegotiate. Len, open the fucking gate. But she's tied up. You know what I mean. Now I must go back to saving the day.
So my brain's like... So you've been treating Higsby as, like, a character you like. So I'm imagining he's probably just being possessed or some shit.
Huh?
Or he gets a redemption arc.
Where is the possibility?
Do you have to go back to the other classroom?
Where? That would make no sense. Let's look at the re-education program. Yeah, but... How?
Well,
oh, wait, no. No, wait, there's one more that I need to get to. Yeah, no, Higsby gets... After this arc, Higsby makes a face heel turn, as it were.
Oh, okay, so it's a redemption arc. Cool.
Yeah, no, he's redeemed pretty quickly. And then he becomes, like, one of the best NPCs ever. He also takes all of your money, but that's a story for a different time. There we go.
That's not Flashman.
Nah, Flashman doesn't interfere.
Oh, that's the one that played them.
This is Number Man. Ah, nah, yeah, no,
whoa,
I can.
Whoa, whoa.
I can see why you would get confused, because 3 also starts out with you going into school first.
Every man has a price.
Yes. I mean, I can't blame the man. You have to work. And I'm assuming, like, rare cards, chips are expensive.
You'll find ramen tastes the same.
You'll find ramen tastes the same. This is Number Man. The first original Navi for the Battle Network series. Number Man is actually really piss easy. He does not move from the spot.
So what's the point? Oh!
Uh-huh.
Got it.
To use numbers to your advantage. Having a charge cut here is very useful. Because any number that is above the number
less than
eight.
16, yeah.
No, actually, any number less than 8 is instantly destroyed because you've got the semi-charge shot. And I gotta go through the milling all over again. Why? My folder really isn't optimized for this fight. And then
how do you optimize your folder anyway?
Well, because you can't move from that spot, I should not have swords in there.
Ah.
Because they can't reach them at all. If I had more area steals, then that would be a lot better. Then I could actually get more swords, but I don't think so. Let's thin out the floor.
Can you damage him while he's doing that load up?
Well, yeah, but the balls generally spawn pretty quickly, so they end up absorbing the damage anyway. So,
gotcha.
Point is just to shoot through them, basically. Unfortunately, the charge shot charges a bit too slowly that you can sneak a cheeky shot in between them. If I had enough money, I was actually gonna buy another power up and hopefully increase that. Here we go. That's my knowledge of the alphabet, H-I-N-J.
Oh, that has to be in alphabetical order?
Yes, it has to be in alphabetical order. And you get Z-Spray.
So it's spreaders for an unlimited amount of time?
Yeah. Program bosses in this game are actually kind of shit, to be fair. Well, most of them are kind of shit. They get better in Joshi, and get a lot better in Joshi. Because that program of events in 2 and 3 changes from Z-Spread to a program of events called Hyperburst, which fires a spreader that hits multiple times, doing up to 500 damage. Okay. And it also hits the area around whatever you hit. And when you I think I've actually run through all my chips. Shit.
Have you run?
Well, then you've got to use the buster. So this is going to be a war of attrition, basically. Oh wait, no, I haven't. Never mind. And when you use in tandem with a chip called Prism, can max out about 1 to 1500 damage in one shot. Because the way Prism works is that it reflects whatever. It's basically a bomb type chip, and when you throw that bomb type chip into your opponent's area, anything that hits it gets reflected across the area.
Okay.
It's actually a really cool chip. I love the combination because you can pull off a lot of shenanigans with it. C. Actually, yeah, no, that kind of gets fixed as well. I think it only does one shot in this game, but does multiple hits in 2 onwards. I'm not showing off with these dice bombs, depending on what number the die roll lands
that's
on.
That's the score you have to beat.
No. That's how much damage the explosion will do.
Oh.
So it can do up to a maximum of 60 damage.
Gotcha. That's cool.
Yeah, no. Number Man's an interesting boss design.
I certainly read it more interesting than he sounds.
He is boring, but his concept alone is interesting. And in later games where he comes back as a boss, they beef him up a tad. And he throws protractors.
What?
Or is it set squares?
What? How does... What does losing to a child in a poker game teach you about buying rare cards?
What series did you just get done playing?
But that's different.
How is that different? How does losing to a child in a Pokemon battle teach you lessons about not trying to take over the world?
She didn't learn a lesson.
I was referring to Guzma.
Yeah, he didn't learn a lesson from losing a battle.
Okay, fine, Plumeria then.
I remember her.
How do you forget Plumeria? Is that one of the best designs in the game? And that booty. That would have been nice if there was a time around getting the server back up and running with 4 scores out. And the faster you did, you get better rewards, or like the longer it took, something. Yeah, you got to skip class, that would be interesting. There we go, this is where we do the power up.
Alright, well.
Yeah, no, we're gonna call it in a minute. I'm gonna call it when we get to Silo, I think. But that is that done with.
That car is so cute!
Yes. Also, I can jack into it.
It has a face stash. It's a mustache in the wrong place. Yeah. But it's still on the face.
It's a lift car, obviously.
They're different colors. They must be exponentially more powerful.
Pretty much.
I know how RPGs work. So, why is the bug badge in the background now?
What is a bug badge?
A badge that's made to resemble a bug, obviously.
You don't see or you don't know.
Background. Look at it. Little.
That's the Mega Man symbol.
Well, it looks like a ladybug. Looks like a Cybertronic ladybug.
I can see that. Black and red. Ah, there we go. That's a mystery. Right? Yes. More hit points. You know, I'm gonna just go beef up Mega Man and then call it a day. But. I don't want to miss any cutscenes, so. Or maybe not. Okay, this is leading into the next little crisis we have to deal with. But we will get to that later. So, next time we will take a look into this landslide by going on the internet, obviously, because that's how we fix all our problems. But for now, see you later. Enjoy your night. And Jack in safety. I don't have an outro for this one, I'm still working on it.
We don't. That's alright.